Welcome back. Today we're discussing Alzheimer's disease, and good news, there is hope because caregivers and researchers are working tirelessly to fight the disease. Jenn Briand is back to discuss the work that Alzheimer's Association does to battle Alzheimer's. It's great to have you back for another segment. I do have some follow-up questions on the disease itself, and I know there are people probably watching going, well, wait a second, grandma had it. Mm-hmm. Is it hereditary? Can I get it? Mm-hmm. Is it a hereditary disease?
So it is. It can be. It's in my family. My grandmother was diagnosed with dementia. Her brother was formally diagnosed with Alzheimer's. My dad is in his mid to late 60s. I think about it a lot. That doesn't mean he's definitely going to have it, but his chances are greater than somebody who doesn't have it in their family at all. I would definitely say, again, just if you're concerned, talk to your general practitioner and get testing underway. But just because you have it in your family, that doesn't mean you're absolutely going to get it. Not at all.
Is there a cure?
There's no cure.
No cure.
No cure.
Are we making
progress? Very promising research. Oh, absolutely. Absolutely.
Well, that's where your association comes in because, in fact, why don't you tell us about it?
Okay. So the Alzheimer's Association was founded in 1980 in Chicago, and it was founded by a group of caregivers who all had a connection to Alzheimer's and decided, you know, we want to band together and we want to do something about it. So our organization is relatively young compared to a lot of other large voluntary health organizations. So your American Cancer Societies, your Leukemia and Lymphoma Societies, they've been around for almost 100 years, if not more than 100 years. So we're the babies of the group. We've been around, like I said, for about 40 years now. And our mission is to enhance research, enhance care and support, and to your point, find that cure and fund research to find that cure. So we are the leading nonprofit funder of research globally, and we're only behind the US government and the Chinese government in funding for research. We also advocate for research, and we go to our politicians locally. So in Raleigh, we have a state advocacy day every year. We have an advocacy forum in Washington every year. We have 1,200 folks like you and I talk to legislators and talk to Congress about, you know, passing more funding and more laws to help people with Alzheimer's disease. So we do a lot of things.
Well, and thank you for that. We all appreciate that. Raising awareness is probably part of it as well for the general community, although it sounds like with the number of people being afflicted today, that's probably not too big of a problem, is it?
Well, it's not too big of a problem, but there's still a stigma associated with Alzheimer's. So,
explain that. What do you mean, stigma?
So people don't want to talk about it as much. So as I kind of spoke a tiny bit about earlier, the later stages of Alzheimer's can be isolating. You know, you're not able to, you know, use the bathroom on your own. The person might not be able to speak to others on their own. And it's hard to relate to that. It's hard to talk about it. It's also one of the most expensive diseases to fund. So families are often, you know, trying to find the best way to take care of their loved one. And that's a huge stressor. So there are all of those things that kind of, you know, come together to say, we don't really want to be open about this. Whereas with cancer, there's been a ton of funding over the years. Cancer is funded, I believe, 8 times as much by the NIH than Alzheimer's is. So we just passed recent funding and additional research funding through the NIH. So we're now up to $2.1 billion in funding for research, but we still have a long way to go to reach that threshold where cancer is. So until there are drugs available that are able to do more than minimize symptoms, people are not as apt to talk about it because there's no cure.
You know, Alzheimer's affects the person, but it affects the whole family.
Affects the whole family.
Where do you go if you have a family member who's going through this? Where do you go for support? Where do you go for financial help?
So I'm so glad that you asked that question, because one of the other greatest resources of the Alzheimer's Association is our 24/7 helpline. So if folks at home take nothing else from this conversation, utilize that 24/7 helpline, 1-800-272-3900. There are folks in Chicago, Alzheimer's Association employees, who are available to answer questions 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, on holidays, nights, weekends. And basically, they're able to help folks who are in crisis, and they can also just answer general questions. So they can help you find a long-term care facility in Arkansas. They can help you find a doctor in New York City. They can answer general questions, and if it's a true crisis, there are care consultations that are able to be had, and those folks are master's level clinicians, so they're able to have those tough conversations with families. So I would say call the 24/7 helpline if you have any questions at all, and then our website is super robust. There's a ton of resources on there as well. ALZ.org is our website. And the Caregiver Center on our website has tons of blog posts, real people, real families talking about their struggles, getting advice from one another. There's nothing more therapeutic than being able to read the words of somebody who's walking through the same path as you. So those are the two places that I would go ASAP.
Yeah, feeling not alone is a big deal.
It's absolutely
a huge deal. You talked about research. What kind of progress has been made over the years? You know, if you were to look over your shoulder, where are we today compared to yesterday?
So we have made a lot of progress, and there is a lot of hope. We have a couple of drugs that are in the closing stages, phase three trials, that look really, really good. Biogen has been in the news lately as well about their most recent drug. So today, there are a couple of drugs available that can minimize symptoms. So minimize symptoms of forgetfulness, of getting agitated and frustrated. Those drugs are available right now. With the additional funding that Congress just passed, like I said earlier, we're up to $2.1 billion in federal funding through the NIH to find a cure for this disease. The most progress that we're gonna make is right now. People are excited about this funding. The NIH is putting this money into research in universities where they are, you know, trying new things and being innovative. And the Alzheimer's Association does that as well. So we have our own research study. It's called the U.S. Pointer Study, and basically that looks at healthy living and exercise and eating habits. And there's one site right here in North Carolina at Wake Forest University, and then there's another site up in North Nevada, I believe, Northern California, Northern Nevada. And basically these two sites are looking at folks in their 60s, 70s, and 80s and trying to determine whether your a healthy lifestyle and exercise really does affect Alzheimer's disease. And other new research that just came out that's exciting showcases that healthy heart diets, which we've all heard about, you know, heart healthy food and, you know, walking and running and doing exercise actually does also help your brain as well. So these recent developments are out there, they're helping, they're making a difference, and there's a ton of hope, and I think that that next big drug is on the horizon. We're still waiting for it, but it's out there.
Well, that's exciting. It is. So Jen, let me ask you this. You're obviously very knowledgeable and pretty passionate about this. Why did you get involved?
So I've spent my career up to this point in nonprofit. I've been a fundraiser from the get-go. I love a good cause, a worthy cause. And when I relocated to North Carolina, I was looking for a job, and this special events position popped up at the Alzheimer's Association, and it caught my eye because it married, you know, what I love to do, which is fundraising professionally, but also helping people with Alzheimer's disease. My grandmother had Alzheimer's. I was 12 when she was diagnosed, and all I remember is her wetting the bed at night. She lived in Florida. She was far away. I didn't see her nearly as often as I would like. And I remember the next morning, I was like, why did Grandma wet the bed? I don't understand. And he was like, it's okay. She's sick. I'm gonna take care of it. Don't worry about it. And at that point, that was when I noticed, you know, she had all of our names written on the fridge on little pieces of paper so she'd remember who we were. And that was the last time I saw her in her house. She was then moved to a facility and she passed away sometime later. So, you know, that experience stuck with my family. I mean, we didn't know the Alzheimer's Association existed at that point. My dad was taking care of her long distance from New Jersey. And when I saw this opening, I was like, well, this is an opportunity for me to raise money and do good and also, you know, help a disease that's affected my family and my husband's family as well.
There's probably people watching who would like to get involved. How do they do that? What kind of events do you have coming up?
Awesome. We have a ton of really cool events coming up. Our two signature events are the Walk to End Alzheimer's and the Longest Day. Our walks are being held in over 600 communities nationwide. Our closest walk to Raleigh is in the Triangle. It's in October. It is one of our largest fundraising events. And then the Longest Day is our second signature event. These events, like I said, are done in chapters all across the country. And the Longest Day is really built around the summer solstice. But what sets our chapter apart is that we have a third event, which is really special, really fun, really engaging, and it's our RivALZ flag football game.
Ooh. That sounds great. That sounds like a lot of fun.
Yeah, that is really, really fun. We are actually one of the top three games in the country, number three, I believe. We raised over $150,000 last year, and the group of young women and young men who come together to make this event happen are just incredible and unbelievable. And that flag football game is coming up on June 13th. It takes place at NC State, and anybody can get involved. You can coach, you can play, you can cheerlead, you can, you know, attend events, raise money, but it's the best way to get involved in the springtime, I think.
Well, thank you, Jen. Thanks for what you do.
Thank you so much for having me.
We're going to come back. I think we're going to talk a little bit about this football game, the flag football players. And you mentioned $150,000. That's no chump change for the Alzheimer's Association. So when we come back, you're going to talk to one of those individuals on the team. Stick around.